Bien. And Sukumoglio, the men's doubles pair from Indonesia, who we're about to watch in the men's doubles final. You have been missing out because they are very, very exciting pair. They're the two-time defending champions here at the India Open. And today they're contesting their eighth consecutive final in tournaments played. And looking to win a fifth consecutive title. In other words, they have won their last four tournaments, trying to make it five in a row. They're up against the Danish combination, the number four seeds, Kim Astrup and Anders Rasmussen. Well, as far as the draw is concerned, the two-time defending champions and world number ones obviously at the top of the draw. Only four seeds are left by quarter-final stage. Only one, the world number ones in that top half of the draw. Three pairs from Indonesia and three pairs from China, meaning that there was only four different nations represented at quarter-final stage. All Indonesian affair in the top half of the draw in semi-finals. The current world number ones coming through quite easily against the former world number ones and two-time former world champions. In the bottom half of the draw, Astrup and Rasmussen are through to the final, which means they are the third different men's doubles pair from Denmark to contest the final here at the India Open. And here come the world number ones, the two-time defending champions, Marcus Spinaldi-Gideon and Kevin Sanjaya Sukumoglio. The Danes, a left and right-handed combination. Kim Astrup, he is the left-hander. Anders Rasmussen bringing up the rear there. First time the Danes have contested a final at this level of competition. If you equate these Super 500 events to the former Super Series, they were twice semi-finalists, and they were twice semi-finalists back in 2016. So this is their first final at this level of competition. This will be the fifth meeting between these two pairs, and the Indonesians have won three of the previous four, including the last one, which was the quarterfinal of that Japan Open last year. The Indonesians came from 18-20 down in that second game before winning three in 43 minutes in that Tokyo encounter. So Apinder Sabharwal from India is our umpire for this one. Well, there's only been three players in the history of the India Open that have ever won three titles here. One of them, Lee Chong Wei in the men's singles, who won in 2011, 13 and 14. And the mixed doubles pair of Tuntui Ahmad and Liliana Nasir, who won three consecutive titles in 2011, 12 and 13. Angga Pratama from Indonesia has contested three finals, and three times he has been beaten in the final. So here is Marcus Spinaldi-Gideon. He will turn 27 next month. Born in Jakarta, and he and his partner are enjoying their 31st week in total as world number ones. 2 years ago, they won the title, beating Angga Pratama and Ricky Suwadi in the final, and then it was a repeat of that final again last year. Kevin Sanjaya Sukumoglio, 22 years of age. And words, he is probably one of the fastest players on a badminton court. Born in Bangiwangi. And as far as their matches are concerned, well, they had a very tight second game of their second round match against Isorie Mat and Namde. The Thai pair, who won the Thailand Masters, the Super 300 event, the first of the HSBC BWF World Tour events, saved four game points in that second game. Semi-final, as I say, against the two-time former world champions. Hassan and Setia One playing together for the first time in 16 months since the 2016 Korean Super Series. Kim Astrup, the left-hander, will turn 26 next month, born in Herning. And he and his partner, currently 14 in the world ranking, but did spend 12 consecutive weeks as world number nines from early March last year. Anders Rasmussen will turn 29 in 11 days' time. And as far as their matches are concerned, well, they went the full distance in the very first round. And their semi-final yesterday against the 2016 World Junior Champions, who had beaten the number two seeds, Boa Mogensen. That was two straight games. So as I was telling you, up into Sabah of India, our umpire for this one, Khraisan Tongtop from Thailand, is the service judge.
Players ready? Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Marcos Fernandi Gideon and Kavi Sanjay Sukamulyo, Indonesia. On my left, Kim Astrup, Anders Karup Rasmussen, Denmark. Kevin Sanjay Sukamulyo to serve to Kim Astrup. Love all. Play.
So the men's doubles final gets underway.
Rasmussen's challenge is called in.
Shocking shot, the very first point of the match. It was clearly out.
Correction out. Service over. One love.
Saying the Danes becoming the third pair from their country to contest the men's doubles final here. And the first was Boa Mogensen, who won the title in 2014. And then a year later, Mads Conrad and Mads Colling lost in the final to Chai Biao and Hong Wei. Incidentally, that was Chai Biao and Hong Wei's only Super Series title.
Ball. Service over. 3-2. 4-2.
Is quite normal nowadays, very short rallies in men's doubles.
Service over 5-4.
More service hold calls.
Service over 5-all.
Good rally. Well, there's me saying we have short rallies. That quite clearly the longest rally of the match. Terrific badminton. Second shots. I think he just had to react to it, but I suspect it probably was going wide.
8-5.
Yeah, I'm sure it was. Oh, my goodness me. That goes down as a poor miss.
9-5.
Five straight points. There was a couple of reaction shots there from Sukumolio in the early stages where he played round the head shots that were just incredible. The final shot leaving the Danes absolutely stranded. It's got to be another long rally. Yeah. We're on the run of points, straight points, comes to an end. And not a moment too soon as far as the Danes are concerned. Oh, it's landed in. And the Indonesians, Gideon and Sukumalio, go to the mid-game interval. Having won 7 of the last 8 points. Minutes played. Kim Nielsen, the Danish coach, for the Indonesians, it is Aryono Merarat.
20 seconds. Coach, return to your chair. Six play.
Yeah, good placement.
Service over, 7-11.
Inspirational play.
Service over, 12-7.
A challenge here from the Danes. Sukumalio deliberately missing the shuttle. No, I hope for his sake it is a help, because otherwise he'll look a bit of a chump. Yeah, it is indeed out.
Challenge unsuccessful, one challenge remaining. 13-7.
As well.
Service over, 14-8. Kevin.
Oh, the umpire's going to have a word with Kevin Sanjaya.
Don't do any gesture.
Well, I think the problem was showing his fist.
Play.
Wide.
Service over, 9-14.
Oh, what a routine. He sliced that.
Service over, 15.
Create the deception.
Yeah. 16-9. Service over, 10-16.
So quick.
Service over, 17-10.
Ugh, what a drop shot. Still wide. And the world number ones are quite frankly toying with their opponents at the moment.
19-10.
2 points away from this opening game. It's a good little spell, but one suspects it's too little too late from the Danes in this opening game. Game point opportunities for Gideon and Sukkamoglio.
Kevin. When we're returning the shuttle.
The Danes being told off. I'm not quite sure what
30.
For.
Service fault.
Service fault is called.
Service over.
Racket not pointing in the downward direction, says the service judge.
Fault.
Second time of asking, and the opening game. To the two-time defending champions, Marcus Fernaldi Gideon and Kevin Sanjaya Sukkamoglio. 21-14 confirms the umpire in just 16 minutes of play. Pairs find it difficult to deal with Gideon and Sukumonio.
Second game, love all, play.
I was saying they've won their last four tournaments. Just to recap that, the China Super Series, the Hong Kong Super Series, the Super Series finals at the end of last year, and then they won their first title tournament of this year, the Indonesian Masters last week. So four in a row, they're going for five in a row, and they're one game away from doing so. Brilliant.
Two, love.
Oh, that's unbelievable defense. Clash of brackets. Yeah. Well worked. You have to be persistent. You have to be patient. And I know it's frustrating that the Indonesians, through their sheer brilliance, they keep shuttles coming back that you certainly don't expect to come back. In fact, you expect them to be winners. But if you want to beat them, you've got to keep the patience. You've got to keep the belief. Well, I think you should always expect the unexpected with Sukumolio.
Three.
Neither of the names were expecting him to block that. Oh, I thought that may have been going wide. Yeah, just proving the point that I've been making. Shuttles come back that you really don't expect to be coming back. You've got to stick with it.
Two, three. Play.
Back level. Three all.
Three all.
Just too good.
Savisova, 4-3. Game master.
Another reason for the dead eye. A bit of feather, I think, in the eye.
Play.
Stepping in on that, the Indonesians defensively, and actually got in each other's way.
Savisova, 6-4.
Well, Kim Astrup trying a little bit of trickery himself, but Kevin Sanjaya is just simply too quick to be fooled by that.
Even if
he starts in the wrong direction, he's got the speed to change direction and deal with it. Four straight points.
Player let. Rasmussen, receive. Receive.
Well, proving that he's no slouch at the net either.
10-4.
1-2-3. And another.
Service over.
Well, the run of 5 points comes to an end. And it would certainly help the Danes psychologically if they could try and close down this gap and make it much closer before the mid-game interval. I don't believe it. And again. Ah, misses on probably one of the easiest opportunities in the rally. Yeah, how did I miss that? This second game so far. To the mid-game interval with a 4-point advantage, the number one seeds and two-time defending champions. The call from Upinder Sabharwal of 20 seconds, and Kim Nielsen still talking to his players. Yeah, he's still talking.
7. Play.
Been three or four times already in this match service that the Danes have hit down in between the two 11. Indonesian players, like that one, and the two Indonesians getting in each other's way. Really not sure who's going for the one down the centre. Play. Flat, goes long of the back line.
10, 11.
Yeah, that's just 1 point in it. All 3 points since the mid-game interval. And by Leg. The Danes.
Service over, 11, 12. Play. Rasmussen, receive. Don't delay.
Good return. It's not only that he's reading it, the timing on that shot, because he's got quite a big swing of the racket, has to be perfect. And indeed it is perfect.
Play.
Couple of defensive shots there from Sukumolio. Well, they had a 4 point cushion at the mid-game interval and they've restored that advantage once again, but not for long.
Service over, 12, 15.
Oh, that's well in. total misjudgment from Gideon.
13-15.
Oh dear, service error. That's his second.
Plus
he's being faulted on his serve. That's 3 points he's gifted away.
Play.
Oh, my goodness gracious. Shuttle getting stuck in the racket strings there with the strings breaking.
17-13.
Yeah, good return.
Service over, 14-17.
Well, you sense that it's sort of now or never as far as the Danes are concerned. They've got to start closing down this gap.
Thank you. Players back on court.
Oh my goodness me. You cannot see that drop coming at all.
Service over, 18-15.
Well, 3 point advantage and 3 points away from the third consecutive title here at the Indian Open. There's no way that was coming back. Match point opportunities. 5 match point opportunities for a 5th consecutive title in 5 tournaments played. Oh, very nearly in. That was a behind the back backhand.
16-20.
That's gone long in their 8th consecutive tournament final. They win their 5th consecutive title. Marcus Fernaldi Gideon and Kevin Sanjaya Sukumolio are quite simply a class above the rest.
Marcus Fernaldi Gideon, Kevin Sanjaya Sukumolio, 21-14. 21-16.
21-14, 21-16 in 38 minutes. A third consecutive title here at the Indian Open. And this is where it all started for them as far as major titles is concerned. When they won here 2 years ago, who would have thought of the many great things that were to come. their 14th career title, their second World Tour title in two consecutive weeks.
We shall now proceed with the medal ceremony for the men's doubles. The silver medalists of the men's doubles, Kim Astrup and Anders Karup Rasmussen, Denmark. And the gold medalists, Marcus Fernandi Gideon
sort of level, and
Kevin
they're obviously
Sanjaya
disappointed.
Sukumajo, Indonesia.
But this pair are so clearly
Mary
the best
Quest
in the world right now.
Vice President, Badminton Association of India,
Gideon
to do the
and
honors
Sub
of
Camolio.
Presenting the silver medalists.
Won a record 7 Super Series titles last year from 9 Super Series tournament finals. No other men's doubles pair had done that before them.
Thank you, sir.
And now,
may I request Mr. Shri Prabhu
in 2018, the first
Vice
two
President
tournaments that they played,
Badminton Association of India,
won yet
to do the
two
honors
titles.
Of presenting the gold medals to the winners. Marcus Fernandi Gideon and Kevin Sanjaya Sukumajo, Indonesia. Thank you, sir. May I now request Mr. Arvind Singhal to present the stoles to the finalists, the silver medalists and the gold medalists. Thank you, sir. May I now request Mr. Vishu Tolan, Vice President, BWF, to present the bouquets to the winners. The silver medalist Kim Astrup and Anders Karup Rasmussen, Denmark. And the gold medalist Marcus Fernandi Gideon and Kevin Sanjaya Sukumajo, Indonesia. Thank you, sir. May I now request Mr. Sagar Das, Vice President, Badminton Association of India, to present the souvenirs to the silver medalists. Thank you, sir. May I now request Mr. Ashok Bajaj, Treasurer, Badminton Association of India, to present the souvenirs to the gold medalists. Thank you, sir. May I now request Mr. Vikram Dhar, Managing Director, Yonex, to present the prize money check to the silver medalists. Thank you, sir. May I now request Mr. S.A. Rawal, Vice President, Badminton Association of India, to present the prize money check to the gold medalists. Let's give it up for the silver medalists, Kim Astrup and Anders Karup Rasmussen, Denmark. Let's put our hands together for the gold medalists, Marcus Fernandi Gideon and Kevin Sanjaya Sukumajo, Indonesia.
Well, they are a stunning combination. So exciting to watch. Gideon and Saul Camoli on an incredible fifth consecutive title in five tournaments played. Well, there's just one more final to come, and it's the one that so many of the home fans have come to watch. It's the defending champion, Pusala Venkata Sindhu, against Zhang Bei Wen, representing the United States of America.